I'm Dr. Mary Frances Barthel. I'm the Chief Quality and Safety Officer for Blessing Health System and the Clinical Lead for Infection Prevention. I also work as a hospitalist here at Blessing Hospital. As we read more about coronavirus, what's uncertain is if and when it will affect the Quincy area and the Blessing Health System community. So I think in the meantime, we can keep a few things in mind. One is be cautious and prepared, but not panic. The spread of this virus, like all other viruses, is primarily droplet, and you're most apt to come in contact with it by touching surfaces that have been contaminated by infected individuals. That's why washing your hands remains the number one first line of defense against catching this and other viruses and bacterial infections. So washing your hands with soap and water or the use of alcohol, hand sanitizer, before and after you eat, before and after you use the bathroom, before and after you sneeze or cough, or even touch your face, all of those things are going to be your first line of defense, much more important than wearing a mask or any of the other personal protective equipment you might have seen. If you do become ill, it's important that you stay home from school or work so as not to come into contact with other people. If you're doing a lot of coughing and sneezing, it's better hygiene to do that into the crook of your arm or your shoulder than it is to use your hand because you're going to be touching surfaces that other people might touch afterwards. But staying home when you're sick is essential to stop the spread through the community. If you do become ill, right now, one of the most pertinent questions is, have you had any travel outside the continental United States? If you have not, then you are far more likely to have an illness with influenza or with another virus than you are with the novel coronavirus. If you have had travel outside of the United States and you have a fever with cough or shortness of breath, then we would want you to go ahead and call your primary care provider before coming in for care so that we can ask a couple of screening questions so that we know how to appropriately take care of you when you arrive. That would be our suggestion at this point. Our infection prevention program is working with all of the clinical providers in the area and all of the local health departments to make sure that we are up on the latest recommendations from CDC. So the easiest thing to do is to go ahead and give us a call before you arrive so that we can prepare.